This is Nina Curley here chatting with Melih Odimiş, the co-founder of Yemek Sepeti, Turkey's largest food ordering and delivery portal. So how did you initially decide to create a portal for food delivery?
Actually, you know, the idea is pretty old. I mean, we have started in 2000 and at the end of 2000. And the original idea came from US, actually. I mean, the idea of ordering food online. It was like, you know, there were the websites webvan.com, cosmo.com, or like some online fast food delivery companies like pizza companies, etc. in US. But we have changed the idea quite a bit. I mean, we have customized it for Turkey in 2000. I mean, with asking no charge extra fee from the restaurant, asking no fees from the customer, etc. So we changed the idea a lot. And actually, it was quite a need, I mean.
Would you say that your innovation is primarily in localizing the model? Or would you say that the innovation is mostly in the software solution that you developed to handle the orders?
Both, actually, I can say. I mean, because initially it was the adaptation of the idea into Turkish market, because in terms of revenue, it's a quite a hard business model. However, when you build a business model like this with a huge network effect and on a marketplace like this, you create a really defendable, high barrier entry business. However, at later stage, when, let's say, we were getting around 1,000 orders, 1,500 orders a day, that was around 2003, 2004, the innovation got a lot more around technology and the software and the handling of that huge amount of real-time orders, where we handle like close to 50,000 orders a day now.
So as you've scaled over the last 12 years, how have you adapted to running such a large company?
I mean, starting a business at the age of 24, it's like a big venture. I mean, you start like, you are courageous and you are excited. And of course, you don't have a lot to lose. Becoming a company like with 20 people, from 20 people up to like a company with 60 people, 70 people, lots of things change. As you know, the critical number of people are around 30 and 40. Until that, you are still a single entrepreneur and you do everything yourself, actually, pretty much. And then you have to learn how to manage people, how to manage processes. You have to put in processes. You have to become more structural. You have to put on procedures, etc. So corporate governance kicks in, etc. So you learn on the way how to adapt and you become more like a manager than an entrepreneur. So now, and after, especially after 2007-08, we became more managers than we were like entrepreneurs, although we like ourselves, we like to see ourselves still as entrepreneurs, as we like to do new things always, and we try to stay innovative in the company as much as we can.
What do you think the biggest factor in your success was?
Part of success, in our success, I would say that it's patience. I mean, because in the first 4 years until 2004, it was all about survival. And we could easily give up like many other companies did in Turkey. But we didn't. I mean, we believed in the company. As partners, we stayed together and we believed in the idea. We stayed there. Although we couldn't make any money for ourselves, the first salary that I got from the company, it's in 2003, and it was around like $500. So, I mean, I risked myself, my time, like my career, everything for 3-4 years, not making any money. I had a great academic career and I could like easily work somewhere else and make good money to live with. So I guess we sacrificed a lot. And then that came back to us, rewarded us, starting from 2004. And after that, until 2004, I say it was patience. But after that, I say it's good execution and like good team. Like we were always together as partners. We are still the managing founding partners. As managing partners, we are still in the company, and we still focus on the very core business that we started the first day. That's also very important, I believe. Entrepreneurs have always to keep in mind that going after money with the idea, with just at the idea phase stage, it's not something that you should do. I mean, you should always create something and then look for money if you need it.
I know you already operate through Food on Click in Dubai and Abu Dhabi. Any plans with the new investment to expand further in the Arab world and abroad?
Definitely. I mean, Middle East is a very natural area for us to grow, and we will grow in Middle East.
Great. Well, congratulations on your investment and your success, and clearly you guys will only continue to become a global player. Thank you so much for chatting with us.
Thank you very much. You're welcome.